Hello, all greetings. I am Gilles Mancier. I am call and come and say hello to wish you a good day, to pull a few cards and discuss a few ideas. For the, today, it's been a very difficult day for me. It's like spirit is continuing to project those amazing vision of celebration, of partying, of freedom. But in the meantime, I looked at my life, and for the past 10 years, they've been telling me that, and it's been a desert, sentimental, romantic, financial, professional, social. It's like I'm like plugging in the morning. I'm waking up. I'm doing my routine. I'm doing those videos, I paint a few paintings, and then I plug back at night. But nothing happened during the course of the day outside of that which is routine, and that's been going on for 10 years. So maybe I'm thinking that I'm lacking stamina. I have to continue to stay optimistic no matter what and still continue to believe, for it is very important. And I know that when the time comes, things will happen. It's inevitable. So it is. I'm going to pull 10 cards. The Dakini. That corresponds a little bit to, so the situation is cutting through, it's being able to cut through, to find the reform, to reform whatever needs to be reformed. What goes around the situation is the Mount Meru, the center of the universe. Never lose your central focus, for God is always there, and that is the only central focal point, this source, this divine love energy, this eternal light that is our true essence that needs to be not forgotten in the process. What we see before us is the tree spirit, is the ability to grow and to understand the wisdom. For the trees are the symbolic of the beings of wisdom. What we have in our subconscious, the same card that we had in the French reading, it's the Joker, it's the freedom of fear, for we were very insouciant. For in the past, there was I know for myself, in the past, I had all that I ever needed. I was like not concerned with anything. And then eventually, Saturn came back when I was 30 years old to make me face with all my karma. And then ever since then, I've been struggling in some sense to find this balance point between all those karmas. And now what we are, the situation is the hot seat, the seat of the emperor, for there is new responsibility, new empowerment that is coming, that may not yet be completely manifested. What's coming up in the near future that will continue to manifest as we assume more power within ourselves. What we have in the near future is Isis, is the great priestess, is the high priestess, is this the card of intuition. It's about following that intuition no matter what. What we have as strengths is survival. We're still confronted with those lower aspects of the self that is connected to the 3D. But then they will come, soon will come wisdom. We'll discover that oasis in the desert, and we'll be grateful for having been patient and going through all this process of transmutation of the lower energies. What comes to us from the outside world is how she spins. For she's like spinning a tapestry. It is Maya that is spinning. It's like the illusion is being created day after day, and then the liberation of truth has been weaved into it until we find that point of liberation. What we have in our inner emotion is amusement, is the desire to play, to enjoy, to have fun. And the outcome is slay the ego. It's like letting go of the old. The old is gone. It's about dying and being reborn. The ego is not getting what it wants, so when the ego doesn't get what it wants, it rebels, and so it has to be slayed. And so when we do that, we find totally bananas. There is like everything becomes absurd. We're losing the meaning, the sense of things, and then we have to discover the pearl before swine. We have to discriminate between those things that give us those things, those people, those situations that are aligned with our soul plan, and those that are distracting us from our soul plan. And so eventually we'll find, wow, a lot to deal with. It's the mother of pearl. It's like those pearls of consciousness. It's like the pearl is the imperfection within the pearl, that within the oyster, that creates the pearl. So it's the piece of sand that's been introduced. So it's like all those imperfections are contributing to the evolution of our consciousness. We do not want to go into gloom and doom. And so eventually will come the phoenix. So we have to prepare for that, to be the renaissance, a rebirth, the sun, the highest good. For it's like the light is always darker right before the dawn. So they say. And so I hope this resonated with you, for there is, in many sense, it might reflect some of the things I'm going through. For there is a square between the moon in Aries and Mars in Cancer. So it's like the Mars is in the house of the moon, and the moon is in the house of Mars. And so there is a very, it's very challenging emotionally right now, but it will pass. The moon is going to go on, so it will pass. In a sense, what we want to do is to fuse with the elementals, with the elemental consciousness of the planet, of our own elemental, for to move outside of time into this eternal consciousness of energy that transmute into matter and retransmute into energy. For we're like this great chemical factory. Everything happens really, really fast. Everything is recalibrated on a nanosecond level. It goes beyond our consciousness. So, but everything we're in the midst of great transformation, so we have to allow to let go as much as possible, to understand that the God has, for those who can believe in that, God has created a magnificent universe. You just got to look at how beautiful the universe is, or look at nature. Nature is infinite perfection, it is divine, it is complete. And they say that man is the apex of creation. It is a creature that started from a mono single cell organism that have evolved through time into these great creatures that are able to recognize and identify with the creator. For so that's to also, we also have this responsibility of free will, or assume the responsibility of our creation. But in a sense, I don't think man is the apex of creation. I think woman is the apex of creation. It is the I don't mean to glorify woman over man, but I think a woman is the apex of creation is woman. It's not man. For man and woman, it's like they are a gift to each other. They are complementary. For we all descend from heaven with a mission, but sometimes the condition of our life, we enter this matrix through Arcturus. We were prepared there, we were qualified, we thought everything was fine. We lived in the eternal sphere of incredible wellness, incredible love, incredible well-being, and we decided to partake in this experience of the lower physical experience. And so we enter through this portal, but as soon as we enter the portal, we lose our consciousness and we gain free will. So we are able to create outside of the law, which creates karma, which is, in a sense, we consider it's fair and unfair in the same time, because we chose it, so it's fair. But since we lost our consciousness, sometimes I would wish that I had less free will and more consciousness, more lucidity, more love, so that I can be more in the flow of that which is. But it's also because I'm going through a difficult day, so it's all about resisting or flowing with whatever comes. Also, we have to understand that it is easy to understand that we love to do what we love. But sometimes we have in relationship, we have certain duties, and we have to learn what we have to do to love what we have to do, rather than just what we love, and that sometimes things that we love are not really so necessary. We have to move beyond that. And so there's been some interesting report that they said that the ocean has been cleansed from inside. There is a great cleansing, and so fishing is going to be forbidden for a while. But there's a lot of new fish that are going to be imported into the ocean to satisfy the needs of man. For man is very greedy with this like emptying the ocean. So the galactics had to import new fish that will hopefully be enough to quench the desire for humanity for this kind of food. But it's also said that there's going to be a cleansing of the mountains, starting with the Alps, the Rockies, the Himalayas, and those places are going to need to be evacuated. So I'm very curious to see how they're going to manage that, because hopefully it's not going to be too brutal, but there's like dark, a lot of energy has been accumulated in the mountains and they need to be released, and just the same thing with the ocean. But we're going to have a completely new ecosystem that is going to be emerging. And so, just wanted to come and say hello, regardless of my inner condition, my inner state of being. For everything, we'll find balance. It's just a matter sometimes we have to anchor certain energies and to let go of other energies, for it is important to anchor ourselves into the earth. Sometimes I feel like my mission, I'm here to bring about a new renaissance on the planet, and I've created all this art. But since I'm not able to actually, it's like I don't exist in the art world. I feel like my mission is like throwing stones in the water. It's like I'm doing all of that. Why am I doing that? Why am I here? It's like this questioning. If I'm not able to fulfill my mission on the earth, I'm just here to do to do presence, like an employee that comes and he's just he plugs in at the beginning of the day, plugs out, but in between the day he doesn't do anything. He's just sit there at his desk, and he's like, I'm not just sitting there, I'm doing a lot of work, I'm doing those videos, I'm painting, and I'm doing all kinds of other things. But it's not like I don't feel like fully in my mission. Hopefully the certain things will happen to attune me and open one door, any door that will allow me to put the first step forward, and from there new steps will come. So we'll see, Spirit was saying they will happen in two phases. We'll see what happened. The highest wisdom for us today is the same as in French, is the action. What action do we need to take? What we need to understand is transformation, to allow ourselves to let go of the past in order to change, to be transformed. What we need to do is karma, to balance out this karma, to balance out, to neutralize the negative energies that come from the past, to neutralize it so we can see everything through the eye of love and joy. And the outcome is responsibility. We're getting exactly the same card as we got in a French reading, new responsibility, for we have to be responsible for our thoughts, our words, and our deeds. So it's, sometimes it's like to say less, to think less, to act less, but to do the right action is sometimes more powerful. So so I wanted to also, what we want is to create the spiritual armor so we don't get too distracted by all the shadows of the world. So we need to anchor this energy of the three lower chakras into the earth and move our consciousness to our higher heart, and from there we can create this bubble of energy, this shield of light, this pillar of light that can reinforce us. We're learning to do that, to reinforce our own energies. And the paintings behind me, this is an astronomical painting. I have the first one of that series that made over 100 different of the planets of the solar system. And here it's a portrait of Tali. I thought it was the muse, because there is a muse named Tali, but her name is commonly referred as Thalia. Thalia, the muse of comedy. And so I'm going to do a portrait of the nine muse. This is so that I recognize this painting now, but since I researched it a little bit, as Tali, the great. The grace is, she's the personification of beauty. I'm also going to make a portrait of Aglaé, who's the personification of charm, and the portrait of Euphrosyne, which is the personification of joy. So those are challenging portraits, but they will be really nice. I engage myself in this 12, the series of 12 portraits. I made one of the great muse Urani, the muse of astronomy. I have it finished, so just put it on Instagram yesterday. And this is Tali, but she's very beautiful. I really like her. There's this great deal of dynamism in those portraits. I'm going to finish with an old gospel song. It goes like this: I will follow thee wherever he may go, and near him I always will be. For nothing can keep me away, he is my destiny. I will follow him. Ever since he touched my heart, I knew there isn't an ocean too deep, a mountain so high it can keep me away from his love. So of course, the message that call on God, to reconnect. God is our destiny. There is no other destiny outside of God, for that's the only place where we'll find ourselves. And so I wish you a wonderful day. Thank you for liking, sharing, subscribing, commenting, and I'll talk to you later. Hopefully I will return with a higher frequency. I'll be able to turn my frequency back up, for I'm still working on that, but sometimes it's like, feel like there's still this. For we may all go through those ups and downs, and the more we are sensitive to what's going on inside, the more we are vulnerable to those change in frequency. So it's about stabilizing ourselves as much as possible and trusting the process. So no matter what we go through, is to allow ourselves to stay focused on the light and what is that which is to come. Thank you very much. Namaste.